This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Gwalior State was an Indian kingdom and princely state during the British Raj. It was ruled in subsidiary alliance with the British by the Sindhya dynasty of the Marathas and was entitled to a 21-gun salute. The state took its name from the old town of Gwalior, which, although never the actual capital, was an important place because of its strategic location and the strength of its fort. The state was founded in the early 18th century by Ranoji Sindhya, as part of the Maratha Confederacy under Mahaji Sindhya 1761-1794. Gwalior State became a leading power in northern India, and dominated the affairs of the Confederacy. The Anglo-Maratha Wars brought Gwalior State under British suzerainty, so that it became a princely state of the British Indian Empire. Gwalior was the largest state in the Central India Agency. Under the political supervision of a resident at Gwalior in 1936, the Gwalior Residency was separated from the Central India Agency, and made answerable directly to the Governor-General of India after Indian independence in 1947. The Sindhya rulers acceded to the new Union of India, and Gwalior State was absorbed into the new Indian state of Madhya Bharat. Contents 1 Geography 2 History 21 Rulers 211 Mahaji Sindhya 1761-1794 212 Dalatrao Sindhya 1794-1827-213 Jankajirao II Sindhya 1827-1843-214 Jayajirao Sindhya 1843-1886-22 Development in the Gwalior State 221 Madhavrao II Sindhya 1886-1925-222 George Jiyajirao Sindhya 1925-1948-23 Genealogy 231 Maharajas 3 Administration 4 See also 5 References 6 Further reading Geography The state had a total area of 64,856. Separated it from the native states of Dholpur, Karauli, and Jaipur in the Rajputana Agency, on the east by the British districts of Jalaun and Jhansi in the United Provinces, and by Sagar district in the Central Provinces, on the south by the states of Bhopal, Kilchapur, and Rajgarh, and by the Sairanj Pargana of Tonk State, and on the west by the states of Halawar, Tonk, and Kota in the Rajputana Agency. The Malwa section, which included the city of Ujjain, had an area of 20,774. Daughter of the house was married to the Maratha chief Shahu in 1726. Ranoji, along with Malar Rao Holkar, the founder of the House of Indore, and the Panwar, were authorized by the Peshwa Baji Rao I to collect Chauth 25% of the revenues and Sardeshmukhi 10% over and above the Chauth in the Malwa districts, retaining for his own remuneration half the Mikasa or his remaining 65%. Ranoji fixed his headquarters in the ancient city of Ujjain, which ultimately became the capital of the Sindhya Dominion, and on 19 July 1745 he died near Shujalpur, where his cenotaph stands. He left 3 legitimate sons, Jayappa, Dadaji, and Jatiba, and 2 illegitimate, Tukaji and Mahaji. Jayappa succeeded to the territories of Ranoji, but was killed at Nagore in 1759. He was followed by his son Jankoji, who was taken prisoner at the Third Battle of Panipat in 1761 and put to death, and Mahaji succeeded rulers Mahaji Sindhya 1761-1794. Main article, Mahadaji Shin, personal flag of the ruler of Gwalior Madhavrao I, popularly known as Mahaji, and his successor Dalatrao took a leading part in shaping the history of India during their rule. Mahaji returned from the Deccan to Malwa in 1764, and by 1769 re-established his power there. In 1772 Madhavrao Peshwa died, and in the struggles which ensued Mahaji took an important part, and seized every chance of increasing his power and augmenting his possessions. In 1775 Rigoba Dada Peshwa threw himself on the protection of the British. The reverses which Sindhya's forces met with at the hands of Colonel Goddard after his famous march from Bengal to Gujarat 1778, the fall of Gwalior to Major Popham 1780, and the night attack by Major Kamak, opened his eyes to the strength of the new power which had entered the arena of Indian politics. In 1782 the Treaty of Salbai was made with Sindhya, the chief stipulations being that he should withdraw to Ujjain, and the British north of the Yamuna, and that he should negotiate treaties with the other belligerents. The importance of the treaty can scarcely be exaggerated. It made the British arbiters of peace in India and virtually acknowledged their supremacy, while at the same time Sindhya was recognised as an independent chief and not as a vassal of the Peshwa. A resident, Mr. Anderson, who had negotiated the treaty, was at the same time appointed to Sindhya's court between 1782 and December 1805 Dholpur state was annexed by Gwalior. Scindia took full advantage of the system of neutrality pursued by the British to establish his supremacy over northern India. In this he was assisted by the genius of Benoit de Boin, whose influence in consolidating the power of Mahaji Scindia is seldom estimated at its true value. He was from the Duchy of Savoy, a native of Chambéry, who had served under Lord Clare in the famous Irish Brigade in Fontenoy and elsewhere, and who after many vicissitudes, including imprisonment by the Turks, reached India and for a time held a commission in the 6th Madras Infantry. After resigning his commission he had proposed to travel overland to Russia, but was prevented by the loss of his possessions and papers, stolen, it appears, at the instigation of Mahaji, who was suspicious of his intentions. De Boin finally entered Mahaji's service, and by his genius for organization and command in the field, was instrumental in establishing the Maratha supremacy, commencing with 2 battalions of infantry. He ultimately increased Scindia's regular forces to 3 brigades. With these troops Scindia became a power in northern India. In 1785 Scindia reinstated the Mughal Emperor Shah Alam II on his throne at Delhi, receiving in return the title of Deputy Vakil-ul-Mutlaq or Vice-Regent of the Empire, that of Vakil-ul-Mutlaq being at his request conferred on the Peshwa, his master, as he was pleased to designate him. Many of the principal feudal lords of the empire refused to pay tribute to Scindia. Scindia launched an expedition against the Raja of Jaipur, but withdrew after the inconclusive Battle of Lalsit in 1787. On 17 June 1788 Scindia's armies defeated Ismail Beg, a Mughal noble who resisted the Marathas. The Afghan chief Ghulam Qadir, Ismail Beg's ally, took over Delhi, and deposed and blinded the Emperor Shah Alam, placing a puppet on the Delhi throne. Scindia intervened, taking possession of Delhi on 2 October, restoring Shah Alam to the throne and acting as his protector. Mahaji sent De Boin to crush the forces of Jaipur at Patan the 20th of June 1790 and the armies of Marwar at Merda on 10 September 1790 after the peace made with Tipu Sultan in 1792, Scindia successfully exerted his influence to prevent the completion of a treaty between the British, the Nizam of Hyderabad, and the Peshwa, directed against Tipu. In the same year Scindia carried out the investiture of the Peshwa with the insignia of Vakil-ul-Mutlaq. During the ceremony he professed the greatest humility, even insisting on bearing the Peshwa's slippers, as his father had served an earlier Peshwa. The old Maratha nobles, however, were disgusted, and refused to attend or offer the usual complimentary gifts to Scindia. De Boin defeated the forces of Tukaji Holkar at Lakari on 1 June 1793. Mahaji was now at the zenith of his power, when all his schemes for further aggrandizement were cut short by his sudden death in 1794 at Wanauri near Pune. Dholatrao Scindia 1794-1827. Main article, Dholatrao Scindia. Mahaji left no heir, and was succeeded by Daulat Rao, a grandson of his brother Tukaji, who was scarcely 15 years of age at the time. Daulat Rao looked upon himself as the chief sovereign in India and not as member of the Maratha Confederacy at this time. The death of the young Peshwa, Madhav Rao II 1795, and the troubles which it occasioned, the demise of Tukaji Holkar and the rise of the Yashwant Rao Holkar, together with the intrigues of Nana Phadnavis, threw the country into confusion and enabled Scindia to gain the ascendancy. He also came under the influence of Sarjay Rao Ghatki, the most unprincipled scoundrel of his day, whose daughter he had married 1798. Urged possibly by this advisor, Daulat Rao aimed at increasing his dominions at all costs, and seized territory from the Maratha Panwars of Dar and Diwas. The rising power of Yashwant Rao Holkar of Indore, however, alarmed him. In July 1801, Yashwant Rao appeared before Scindia's capital of Ujjain, and after defeating some battalions under John Hessing, extorted a large sum from its inhabitants, but did not ravage the town in October. However, Sarjay Rao Ghatki took revenge by sacking Indore, razing it almost to the ground, and practicing every form of atrocity on its inhabitants. From this time dates the Gardi Ka Wakt, or period of unrest, as it is still called, during which the whole of central India was overrun by the armies of Scindia and Holkar and their attendant predatory Pindari bands, under Amir Khan and others. De Boin had retired in 1796, and his successor, Pierre Chulier Perron, was a man of a very different stamp, whose determined favoritism of French officers, in defiance of all claims claims to promotion, produced discontent in the regular corps. Finally, on 31 December 1802, the Peshwa signed the Treaty of Bisayn, by which the British were recognised as the paramount power in India. The continual evasion shown by Scindia in all attempts at negotiation brought him into conflict with the British, and his power was completely destroyed in both western and northern India by the British victories at Ahmadnagar, Assay, Asurgar, and Laswari. His famous brigades were annihilated and his military power irretrievably broken. On 30 December 1803, he signed the Treaty of Sergi Anjangan, by which he was obliged to give up his possessions between the Yamuna and the Ganges, the district of Baruch, and other lands in the south of his dominions, and soon after by the Treaty of Burhanpur he agreed to maintain a subsidiary force to be paid for out of the revenues of territory ceded by the treaty. By the 9th article of the Treaty of Sarji Anjangan he was deprived of the fortresses of Gwalior and Gohad. The discontent produced by the last condition almost caused a rupture, and did actually result in the plundering of the residence camp and detention of the resident as a prisoner in 1805. Under the new policy of Lord Cornwallis, Gohad and Gwalior were restored, and the Chambal River was made the northern boundary of the state, while certain claims on Rajput states were abolished, the British government at the same time binding itself to enter into no treaties with Udaipur, Jodhpur, Kota, or any chief tributary to Scindia in Malwa, Mewar, or Marwar in 1811. Daulat Rao annexed the neighbouring kingdom of Chanderi in 1816. Scindia was called on to assist in the suppression of the Pindaris. For some time it was doubtful what line he would take, but he ultimately signed the Treaty of Gwalior in 1817 by which he promised full cooperation. He did not, however, act up to his professions, and connived at the retention of the fort of Asurgar, which had been ceded by the treaty. A fresh treaty in 1818 effected a readjustment of boundaries, Ajmer and other lands being ceded Jankajirao to Scindia 1827-1843. Young Jayaji Rao Scindia, Studying English, 1846. Main article, Jankoji Rao Scindia II. In 1827 Daulat Rao died, leaving no son or adopted heir. His widow, Baiza Bai, adopted Mukit Rao, a boy of 11 belonging to a distant but legitimate branch of the family, who succeeded as Jankajirao Scindia. Jankajirao was a weak ruler and feuds were constant at his court. While the army was in a chronic state of mutiny upon his succession, difficulties arose as to whether the Bai should ruler in her own right or as regent, and her behavior towards the young king finally caused a rise in feeling in his favor, which impelled the Bai to take refuge in British territory. She returned after an interval and lived at Gwalior until her death in 1862. The chief's maternal uncle, known as Mama Sahib, had meanwhile become minister. The most important event during this period was the readjustment of the terms for maintaining the contingent force raised under the Treaty of 1817. Jayajirao Scindia 1843-1886. Main article, Jayajirao Scindia. Jayajirao Scindia, in 1875 Jankajirao died in 1843, and in the absence of an heir, his widow Tara Bai adopted Bhagirath Rao, a son of Hanwant Rao, commonly called Babaji Scindia. He succeeded under the name of Jayajirao Scindia, the Mama Sahib being chosen as regent. Tara Bai, however, came under the influence of Dada Kazgawala, the controller of her household, an unscrupulous adventurer who wished to get all power into his own hands. A complicated series of intrigues followed, which it is impossible to unravel. The Dada, however, succeeded in driving Mama Sahib from the state and became minister. He filled all appointments with his relatives, and matters rapidly passed from bad to worse, ending in the assemblage of large bodies of troops who threatened an attack on Syrinj, where Mama Sahib was then residing. War was impending in the Punjab, and, as it was a essential to secure peace, the British government decided to interfere. Colonel Sleeman, the resident, was withdrawn, and the surrender of Dada Kazgawala was demanded. A British force under Sir Hugh Gough moved on Gwalior, and crossed the Chambal in December 1843. On 29 December followed the simultaneous battles of Panyur and Maharajpur, in which the Gwalior army was annihilated. A treaty was then made, under which certain lands to the value of 18. June 1858 Gwalior was captured by Sir Hugh Rose and Maharaja Sri Jayajirao was reinstated. For his services lands worth 300,000 per year, including the portion of Chanderi district west of the Bedwa River, were made over, and he was allowed to increase his infantry from 3,000 to 5,000 men, and his artillery from 32 to 36 guns. In 1858 Gwalior annexed Chanderi state development in the Gwalior state. Madhav Rao Scindia about 1903 George Jayajirao Scindia Maharajya Jayajirao Shind was the founder of development in Gwalior after 1857 and worked for the peoples of Gwalior to establish their own business. He was a very good artist of Gwalior Gharana classical music and opened a school for learning music. The Gwalior got its music in his region. It was his sole efforts that made Gwalior the most advanced city of India. GCB, Knight Grand Cross Order of the Bath Medal 111,877, GCSI 2,561,861, C 111,878. In 1872 the state lent 75 British troops since 1858, were exchanged for Jhansi City. Madhavrao II Sindhya 1886-1925. Main article, Madho Rao Sindhya. Jayaji Rao died in 1886 and was succeeded by his son, Madho Rao Sindhya, then a boy in his 10th year. A council of regency conducted the administration until 1894, when the Maharaja obtained powers. He took a deep and active interest in the administration of the state, and had a comprehensive grasp of the work done in each department. In 1900 the Maharaja went to China during the Boxer Rebellion, at the same time presenting a hospital ship for the accommodation of the wounded George Jayajirao Sindhya 1925-1948. Main article, George Jayajirao Sindhya. George Jayajirao Sindhya ruled the state of Gwalior as absolute monarch until shortly after India's independence on 15 August 1947. The rulers of Indian princely states had the choice of acceding to either of the two dominions, India and Pakistan, created by the India Independence Act 1947, or remaining outside them. Jayajirao signed a covenant with the rulers of the adjoining princely states that united their several states to form a new state within the Union of India known as Madhya Bharat. This new covenanted state was to be governed by a council headed by a ruler to be known as the Rajpramukh. Madhya Bharat signed a fresh instrument of accession with the Indian Dominion effective from 15 June 1948. Jayajirao became the first Rajpramukh, or appointed governor, of the state on 28 May 1948. He served as Rajpramukh until 31 October 1956, when the state was merged into Madhya Pradesh. Genealogy. The rulers of Gwalior bore the title of Maharaja Sindhya. Maharajas 1731-19 July 1745. Ranajirao Sindhya d. 1745, 19 July 1745 to the 25th of July 1755. Jayaparao Sindhya d. 1755, the 25th of July 1755 to the 15th of January 1761. Jankajirao I Sindhya b. 1745, d. 1761, the 25th of July 1755 to the 10th of January 1760. Dadaji Regent d. 1760, the 15th of January 1761 to the 25th of November 1763. Interregnum, the 25th of November 1763 to the 10th of July 1764. Kadarjirao Sindhya. Kadarjirao the 10th of July 1764 to the 18th of January 1768. Manajirao Sindhya daf 1777, the 18th of January 1768 to the 12th of February 1794. Madhavrao I Sindhya BC 1727 D 1794, the 12th of February 1794 to the 21st of March 1827. Dalitrao Sindhya B 1779 D 1827, the 21st of March 1827 to the 17th of June 1827. Maharani Bija Bai F Regent B 1787 D 1862, the 17th of June 1827 to the 7th of February 1843. First time, the 17th of June 1827 to the 7th of February 1843. Jankajirao II Sindhya. Jayajirao Sindhya B 1805 D 1843, the 17th of June 1827 to December 1832. Maharani Bija Bai F Regent saw second time, the 7th of February 1843 to the 20th of June 1886. Jayajirao Sindhya B 1835 D 1886 from the 25th of June 1861. Sir Jayajirao Sindhya, the 7th of February 1843 to the 13th of January 1844. Maharani Tara Bai F Regent B 1831 D 1843. January 1844. Dada Khasjawala in rebellion, the 20th of June 1886 to the 5th of June 1925. Madhavrao II Sindhya B 1876 D 1925 from the 25th of May 1895. Sir Madhavrao II Sindhya, the 17th of August 1886 to the 15th of December 1894. Maharani Sakyabai F Regent B 1862 D 1919, the 5th of June 1925 to the 15th of August 1946. 1947 George Javaji Rao Sindhya B 1916-1961 from 1 January 1941, Sir George Javaji Rao Sindhya 5 June 1925 to 23 November 1931 Maharani Chinku Bai F Regent D 1931 23 November 1931 to 22 November 1936 Maharani Gajra Rajabai F Regent D 1943 Administration for administrative purposes the state was divided into two prants or divisions, Northern Gwalior and Malwa. Northern Gwalior comprised seven zillas or districts, Gwalior Gurd, Bihind, Shiapur, Tanwargarh, Isagar, Bilsa, and Narwar. The Malwa prant comprises four zillas, Ujjain, Mandsaur, Shahapur, and Amjira. The zillas were subdivided into parganas, the villages in a pargana being grouped into circles, each under a patwari. The administration of the state was controlled by the Maharaja, assisted by the Sadar Board. This board consisted of seven members, the Maharaja himself being president and the members being in charge of different departments, of which the most important were the revenue, land records and settlement, forest, accounts, public works, customs, and post office. The Maharaja had no minister, but a staff of secretaries, supervised by a chief secretary, prepared cases for the final orders of the Maharaja. The zillas were overseen by subas, or district magistrates. In Northern Gwalior, the subas answered directly to the Sadar Board, while in Malwa, a Sar Subha was in general charge of the Malwa Prant, and controlled and oversaw the work of the four Malwa Subhas. The numerous feudal estates under Gwalior were administered by the local rulers, and were outside the administration of the Zillas and Prants. The small estates Thakurs or Dewans of Sangal Wardhagra were nominally under the authority of Gwalior State, but the British resident had certain administrative and judicial powers. See also Political Integration of India. List of Maratha dynasties and states. List of Indian princely states. References. Karat Gwalior, Princely State. 21 Gun Salute. Karat Bolan Crew, Tara, Lee, David. 2004 The Territories and States of India. Psychology Press. ISBN. Modern World. Bloomsbury Publishing. pp. Jofrilo, Christoph. 1999 The Hindu Nationalist Movement and Indian Politics, 1925-1990s. Reprinted ed. Penguin Books India. ISBN. Rajaram II Shahu II Peshwas Moro Pant Trimbak Pingal Moreshvar Pingale Ramchandra Pant Amatya Bahiroji Pingale Parashoram Trimbak Kulkarni Balaji Visvanath Bajirao I Balaji Baji Rao Madhavrao Bilal Narayanrao Raghunathrao Sawai Madhavrao Baji Rao II Amru Rao Nana Sahib Bhat family women Ahilyabai Holkar Anandibai Gopikabai Jankibai Jijabai Kashibai Mastani Mudupalani Parvatabai Putalabai Radhikabai Ramabai Saibai Sakvarbai Soyarabai Umabai Dabade. Yesubai Tulsi Bai Holkar Maratha Confederacy Bonsal of Nagpur Gaikwad of Baroda Sindhya of Gwalior Holkar of Indore Subsidiary or Feudatory States Battles Pratapgar Kolhapur Pavan Kind Shakan Surat Parandar Sinhagad Kalyan Bhupalgar Sangamner. Bijapur Raigar 1689 Jinji Satara Kelna Raigar Torna Palkt Mansur I Delhi Bhopal Vasai Gajendragad I Trichinopoly Katwa I II Trichinopoly Katwa II Expeditions in Bengal. Burdwan Udgir II Delhi Atak Peshawar III Panipat Alagaon Rikshabhuvan Panchgan Sanchi Adoni Badami Savanor Bahadur Benda Lalsat Chaksana Patan Karta. Pune 3rd Delhi Asay Laswari Farakabad Bharatpur Kadki Koragan Mahidpur Wars Maratha Mughal War of 27 years Maratha Mysore War 1st Anglo-Maratha War 2nd Anglo-Maratha War 3rd Anglo-Maratha War Adversaries Adilshahi Nizamshahi Berar Sultanate Bidar Sultanate Qutbishahi Mughal Empire Durrani Empire British Empire Portuguese Empire Nizam of Hyderabad Mysore Forts Fort Mangad Panhala Pratapgad Parandar Raigad Rajgad Shivneri Sindhudurg. Sinhagad Torna Coins Shivray VE Former Princely States in Central India Salute States Ajaygar Ali Rajpur Bauni Baranda Barwani Banaras Ramnagar Bhopal Bijawar Charkari Desha Diwas Junior Diwas Senior Dar Gwalior Indore Holkar Jayora Jabua Kilchapur Maihar Narsingar Orcha Pana Rajgar Ratlam Rua Ceylana Samthar Satamao. Non-salute states Alipura Badora Basoda Bari Bundelkhand Bisanda Biat Chaturpur Garha Garoli Gorihar Jaitpur Jaiso Jigni Jabat Kamta Rajula Kadiwara Kaniadana. Kathi Kurwai Korwai Lugasi Makrai Maksadangar Mathwar Muhammadgar Nagadi Nigawan Ribai Pahara Pathari Piploda Raghagar Ritanmal Sarila Sohawal Umri Jaggers. Bhakatgar Banka Pahari Bisunda Bijna Bilhari Dotriya Durwai Jamnia Kachhai Baroda Kali Bauri Kamta Rajula Multan Nimkara Ondwa Paldeo Paran Panth Piploda Rajga. Sondwa Tehran Tori Fatehpur. Related topics: Central India Agency, Bagelkhand Agency, Bhopal Agency, Bhopawar Agency, Bundelkhand Agency, Shabe Jaggers Gwalior Residency, Hashed Baya. List of princely states of British India. Alphabetical: Malwa Agency, Sagar and Nerbudda Territories. VE Gun Salute. Princely states during the British Raj. 21 Gun Salute. Baroda, Gwalior, Hyderabad, Jammu, Cochin, Kutch, Jaipur, Jodhpur, Karauli, Kota, Patiala, Pudukkottai, Rua Tonk. 15 Gun Salute. Alwar, Banswara, Desha, Diwas, Dar, Dolpur, Dungarpur, Eder, Jaisalmer, Kerpur, Kishangar, Orcha, Pratapgar, Rampur, Sikkim, Sirohi. 13 Gun Salute. Banaras, Bhavnagar, Kuch, Behar, Dringadra, Jayora, Halawar, Jind, Junagadh, Kapurtala, Naba, Nawanagar, Palanpur, Porbandar, Rajpipla, Ratlam, Tripura. 11 Gun Salute. Ajaygar, Alirajpur, Bauni, Barwani, Bijawar, Bilaspur, Kambe, Chamba, Charkari, Chhatarpur, Chitral, Faridkot, Terry, Garhwal, Gondal, Hanhira, Jafarabad, Jabua, Malerkotla, Mandi, Manipur, Morvi, Narsingar, Panna, Radhanpur, Rajgar, Ceylana, Samthar, Sirmar, Satamahu, Sukat, Wankaner. 9 Gun Salute. Balasanor, Banganapal, Bansda, Baranda, Beria, Bhor, Chota, Udaipur, Danta, Dharampur, Dhrol, Jahar, Kalahandi, Kilchapur, Limgi, Loharu, Lunavada, Maihar, Mayurvanj, Mudhol, Nagad, Palatana, Patna, Raikat, Sachin, Sangli, San, Sawantwadi, Shapura, Sunpur, Wadwan, Yanwe. List of princely states of British India. Alphabetical.